Okay, now that the house cleaning is taken care of, let's continue. First order of business, let's remove the time block. And once we drop down this hole, we will go to the rushing rapids. It's our next step to getting our next small key, and finishing the dungeon as a whole. Speaking of which, we actually don't have too much further to go. A couple small keys, a couple spiders, and then the boss fight itself. Okay, Navi, I'll let this one slide. So we're going to be swimming, and we need to avoid the whirlpools. If you get sucked in, it's the same as falling down a pit. Around this first corner, hug the left. Then hug the right. And now we put on the boots. Did you see the spider? Because I sure did. And I always found this to be a bit of a problem. As soon as I hit the seafloor, I can't always get the hook shot right away. But at least we got it. Okay. And now we need to swim hard to the right, and hopefully we don't get sucked in. Come on, come on, come on, come on! Nice. Alright. Now before we go on, I'm gonna put on a bottle because, if I'm not mistaken, there's a fairy in here. Nice. Alright. And now I'm gonna pull a 180. But first, just to make sure I don't squander the fairy, putting this back on. Alright, here we go. Come on. Damn whirlpools. Gonna be the death of me. Alright, now we shoot the eye. We're gonna be on a very strict timer. The gate will not remain open for very long. So, hookshot it is. Very good. And inside the chest is our next small key. With that taken care of, we're going back to the main hall. And unfortunately, it's at this point where the repetitiveness really kicks in, because now we have to raise and lower the water through one full cycle yet again. Go away. But at least with a long shot in tow, we can actually move to places much quicker. Although at the same time, we gotta do a lot of boot switching, so just bear with me on this one. Alright. Almost back to the center part. So, as per usual, we have to go back to the area where we first encountered Princess Ruto. I do apologize if this seems a little repetitive and tedious, but I can't really help it. No sign of the spike ball, guys, and I want it to stay that way. Okay, here we go. While we cycle through the levels of water, we need to raise the water to the medium level in order to get our last small key. And that's another good reason why we got the long shot, because without it, we would not have been able to get it. I'll explain a little better in detail once we get there, but for now, let's just float. Ouch! Excedrin headache number one. Underwater head bumping. Alright, let's play. I have got to say, I am really getting good at pushing the notes really fast. I mean, it's not as fast as my guitar playing, mind you, but still, pretty good. Although, I will say that I've seen some guys in LPs and on stream play the ocarina really fast. Much faster than me. And to them I say, rock on. Alright, so now we're going back in here. And, no surprise, there's a spider we can get. All we have to do is raise the water, and look up. Okay, Link, time to play Spider-Man. Play it again, Sam. Not as good as last time, but still, fairly well. Okay, now we're gonna jump on that block that's coming up, and then we're gonna look to the ceiling. No, it's not on the ceiling, but pretty damn close. There you are. Yoink! Very well. Okay. Now, this next key is actually one of the more tedious ones to get, because we need to get to a certain area, not once, but twice. Just have to find the right spot. Ah, here it is. It's another one of those cases of being on a very, very strict timer. The gate opens, but it won't remain open for very long. Oh yes, fun fact. If you happen to latch onto the hookshot target just as time expires, you will actually fly through the gate. Now, normally logic would dictate that you would get cut into a million pieces, but you actually go right through. Not sure how that works, but at least it does work. This is probably one of my least favorite parts of the entire dungeon, because it's not overly difficult, but having to repeat yourself so many times, it really bothers me. As I'm sure it bothers a lot of people. Ouch. Okay. There's a tick tat on my tail and I don't want it to be. And there's another one really close by. But if I can get this arrow... There we go. Just hook shot real fast. No trouble at all. Excellent. Alright, Link, get ready to work those legs. Push. Harder. Pump those squanny chicken legs. Move it. Excellent. And there's our last small key. Nothing to it. Okay. Now, before we actually go for the boss key, I'm gonna go raise the water to the highest level, because we need it that way so we can actually open the boss door. So, let's be on our way. Stop screaming, Link. Honestly, are you a man or a woman? Good grab. Ah, yes. Been a while since I've been in this room. Nice try. After what happened last time, I was ready for him. Okay. And after this trip, we will not need to play the Ocarina ever again. Well, at least not inside the water temple. So, once more with feeling. Nice. Gets easier each time I play it. And it shall remain as it is now for all eternity. And now back to boot switching. Really, Link? Are you that much of a chicken shit that you can't take a slight fall into the water? Better than falling on a bed of jagged rocks. Okay. So now, we're gonna go through here. And this is where the long shot will really come in handy. I mean, it's already come in handy. But you know, it's got limitless potential now. It's funny. Even with the iron boots on, this thing will propel me great distances, with relative ease. And once again, it's time to switch boots. This is getting rather tiresome. I get really tired of going back and forth between regular and iron. But it will be over soon. It will be over soon. At least I hope so. Okay, swim. Swim! Okay, I'm up. I'm up. As for you guys, go suck a railroad spike. All of you! Fucking bastards. But I win. But the battle's not over yet. In this room, we have to contend with stingrays. And they're mean little suckers too, but I'm ready for it. Kill them all! Nice. Got all my hearts back. Okay. Now for some bomb action. Let her rip. And once more for good measure. This room's slightly annoying as well. You need to go back and forth to push a block. And I'm not sure if you saw at the bottom of the water, but there's a switch you need to push the block onto. You could try with the iron boots, but like most switches, if you step off of it, it will reset. Okay, now to finish the job. Come on, There we go. That's right. You're doing great. Keep going. And yes, back and forth. Pulling this zigzag pattern can really, really, really rub you the wrong way. But it will be over soon. Not soon enough, though. That's right. Just a few feet more. There we go. It's only a matter of time before we'll have that boss key and we can leave and never come back. Before I forget, better put the long shot back on. And as a measure of safety, shoot him down. What the hell happened to me? Used to be a sharpshooter. Oops. I guess it would help if I had the right weapon. There we go. Now I've got nothing to worry about. However, we are on a timer. Come on, stop jerking around. Made it. Okay, now just through here. If I'm not mistaken, that should be our last spider. I guess I'll know in 1 second. Okay. Line up the shot. Claim the spoils. Hey. Thank you. Now let's check. Yes! Okay. Open up. Thank you. This is getting boring. But whatever. We're almost done. Ah, I saw it. Come to Papa. Excuse me. But after all that trouble, we finally get the boss key. And about damn time, too. Alright, let's finish this. You know, it's really weird, but after all the trouble we went through, the boss is actually not going to be that big of a deal. In fact, at this point, I dare say that this is actually one of the easier bosses in the entire game. But I'm not going to say too much just yet. I'll explain once we get there. Let's outrun the boulder. Climb, climb. Nice. Okay. We're getting very close. Good shot. And finally, our last switch of the boots. One more round with the iron boys. Ugh, not the spike balls. They're actually getting very smart. They actually managed to chase me down the hole. Well, one of them did. Come on, Link, can't you float any faster? This is nuts. Okay, here we are. And no tectites to get in my way. That's the way I like it. Come on, J-Rock, learn to aim. Okay, there we go. Now we're set. One last obstacle to go. The slant run. Come on, faster. Almost there. Come on. That was too close. Look out. That isn't normal water over there. Of course not. It's not even water. As soon as you jump onto one of the platforms, it begins. Something's in there, and it knows we're around. I will say, for the time, it was a rather interesting camera angle. the giant aquatic amoeba known as Morpha. Okay. Now for this fight, you want to get back into the outside, and you want to make sure you stay as far away from it as you can. Back it up. Try me. Push on it out. Slash with a big one on sword. Stop moving around. Missed. Okay, back it up. Back it up. Gotcha. If you're lucky, you can actually get multiple hits on this guy. Dang it. Missed. Targeting. I'm not having a good run on this guy. Okay. Better get far away. What? There's another one? Now you're mine. Get back here. Yes! Flawless victory. Goes the weasel, and the body will evaporate into nothing. It's like that scene in The Wizard of Oz. Hey! You cursed brat! Look what you've done! I'm melting! Melting! Oh, what a world! Who'd have thought a wretched boy like you could destroy my beautiful wickedness? To the last drop. And there's my prize. And it's all mine. And fun was had by all. But I think it's time we got the hell out of here. I spent way too much time in here, more than I'm willing to admit. And we're back in the chamber. No surprise, it's Ruto.
Jeremy, I would have expected no less from the man I chose to be my husband. Zoro's domain and its people will eventually return to their original state. As a reward, I grant my eternal love to you.
Oh, really, Ruto?
You would think, all things considered, you would take a hint by now.
I'm human. You're fish.
It's not gonna work. Well, that's what I want to say, but I don't think I can offer that now.
Well, there you go.
I have to guard the water temple as the Sage of Water. And you, you're searching for the Princess Zelda. Ha! You can't hide anything from me.
Ah, top marks, you are a perceptive one.
Princess Zelda. She's alive. I can sense it, so don't be discouraged. I can tell that nothing will stop you in your quest for justice and peace. You must take this medallion. Take it respectfully.
All right. Now we're cooking with gas. And just like that, our medal count is now at 4. The water medallion. Ruto awakens as a sage and adds her power to mine.
If you see Sheik, please give him my thanks, okay?
Sure. The evil is vanishing from the lake. Jeremy, you did it. You bet your ass I did. is filled with pure water. All is as it was here. Beautiful. Absolutely stunning, especially at sunrise. And look at that, they're the best of friends. Or not. Even though Sheik decided to leave, we'll be seeing him again very, very soon. Much sooner than you think. Relax, Link. It was just Sheik. But he's fine. Okay. Now, before we go, let's do something really quick. Draw the bow and fire away. If I recall correctly, you need to stand in that exact spot for this to work. At the same time, this is a very valuable weapon to have. But before I get too ahead of myself, I'll show you what this thing says. When water fills the lake, shoot for the morning light. And we've done that. Okay, I get it. So, long story short, we get ourselves a new weapon. Combination of regular weaponry and magic. It's the fire arrow. Basically, whatever we shoot sets on fire. Now, the last thing we're going to do before we wrap up the video is go back to the island and change it from day to night. Because if I'm not mistaken, this will be the last spider we need to get every single spider from this area. So, oops. Let's play some music. Was pretty good. Not as good as Zelda's Lullaby, though, but still, I'll consider that a pass. Okay, I gotta get to a better spot. Okay, there we go. Nice. And now the moment of truth. Let's go to the map. Save yet. What I do want to do is get back to solid ground. Good. And now, I think we're going to call it a video. So, thanks for watching, and boy am I glad to be done that water temple. In the next episode, who knows? I might just go fishing again, because there are bigger and better prizes to be had. And I might come across an elusive fish. But, we'll cross that bridge when we get there. So until next time, this is JP, and you've been watching Channel 84 Winnipeg. See you later.